Hi guys! As you can see from the title, today I'm going to talk about my skincare routine. And I've been doing this routine since August, September. I've been using kind of the same products all over, but I've been really, really happy with the results. With a few exceptions, my skin has been glowing and doesn't have a lot of issues. My skin is dry and very sensitive, except for my nose, which is kind of a combination, which means sometimes I can feel it a bit oilier than the rest of my face. So, I'm going to take you step by step of what I do every day. The first step, of course, is cleansing, and I cleanse my face twice a day, morning and night. In the morning time, I like to use the Rêve de Miel face cleansing and makeup removing gel. This is for dry and sensitive skin, but I think there's one for all skin types. Although this is a gel, this doesn't make a lot of lather, so that is good for your skin. You don't need a lot of lather. Nuxe is a French pharmaceutical brand that you can find in Greece, like in every single pharmacy. And the thing is, we can get this here very, very cheap, so this cost me around 10 euro. This is a great cleanser, it's very lightweight, it cleanses your face without leaving it feeling tight, and it smells amazing. For a long time I wanted to try out cleansing balms, and my first choice was by Clinique, and it's the Take the Day Off cleansing balm. I use this cleanser mostly at nighttime, but now that it's a bit colder, I use it in the mornings too, because I feel that it moisturizes my skin, leaves it more nourished. It takes every single bit of makeup off your face. It doesn't leave any trace of makeup, even the most difficult mascara. It doesn't feel luxurious in your skin, but it kind of feels like you have applied lard. It's white and it kind of looks like lard, but it gets the job done. I like it because of that. I like because it's very efficient. It doesn't smell like anything. It doesn't like have anything special, but it gets the job done. To take this cleanser off your face, you don't just need plain water, because I feel that it leaves a film on your face. So I use some kind of a washcloth or flannel with very warm water. It takes everything off and it also feels like spa day. I also wanted to mention Bioderma, because Bioderma I've been using for I don't know how many years. This is a brand new bottle, as you can see, I haven't opened it yet. I used Bioderma before using my Clinique cleansing balm to take most of my makeup off, so this is the first cleanse for me. The second cleanse being my Clinique cleansing balm. But this is very good for sensitive skin types. It's very efficient, so it takes everything off, and it is a very good product. So the next step would be to pat my skin dry with a paper towel. Using a paper towel was recommended to me by dermatologists and beauticians back when I had acne in my teenage years, but I think it works really well because you don't get a lot of bacteria on your face this way. And cleansing, I think, is the most important part of the routine, so you have a cleansed face, a clean face that you can apply everything and it will work better. So I also use this thermal spring water by La Roche-Posay. Aven has one as well. This I use as a rinsing agent. Water in Athens is not the best, I call it crappy water. And if you use one of these thermal waters, it kind of purifies your face from the bad water you just used. This is simply purified water, so it neutralizes your skin. And as I said, everything you put after this, after a good cleansing, is gonna work a lot better. For people with acne who have a lot of problems with bacteria, but also people that have sensitive skin as me, will find this very, very beneficial. Doing this as a step is sometimes thought as something extra, but to me it's not extra. It's something that if I don't do it, I would feel it on my face. The next step is chemical exfoliation, and I've been doing chemical exfoliation with alpha hydroxy acid since summer. And some people do not understand that this kind of exfoliation is more mild for your skin. If you just want to feel some exfoliation on your skin, then power to you, use a normal exfoliant. But I've been using the Clarins Gentle Exfoliator Brightening Toner with tamarind and white nettle. I use it twice a day. It's very mild for my skin. I haven't found that it has reacted to it. I tried the Ren Exfoliating Toner as well back in the summer, and I like this one better because it brightens up my skin even faster. I've been obsessing over toners for the past months, but I have a few favorites, and the first favorite is by Caudalie, and it's the Beauty Elixir. I've been using Beauty Elixir since, I don't know, 2009, so it's been many, many years. And this toner is to add moisture on your skin. It refreshes my skin, it makes it more radiant, and I don't have a lot of breakouts while using this, and my skin is less sensitive. I don't use this every day, but I like to use it a couple times a week because sometimes I feel that my skin looks very dull and weird and I look like sick. And I like to use this. It gives me so much radiance. It absolutely makes a difference. So yeah, I love this. I will continue using this as long as I live, probably. I don't know. And the next toner is by the brand Suti, and it's the organic facial toner with peppermint. This I showed in a favorites video. I think it was October. And yes, I really like it. I like to use this one in the morning because it has that refreshing scent of peppermint and that wakes me up. Another toner I've started using recently is by the brand Bifas, I think it's called, and it's the face soft toner lotion with rose water. Rose water is very good for your skin, but I find that if you just use rose water straight from the bottle, it won't do a lot for your skin. This one doesn't have only rose water, it also has chamomile extract, castor oil, glycerin. It has so many good stuff, and I use this to add moisture to my skin as well after I do my exfoliation. And it was like dirt cheap. I got this for 3 euro, and it's 500 ml. It's gonna last me forever. I like using oils in certain areas on my skin, and I really, really like the Trilogy Organic Rosehip Oil. I have talked about this oil like on my last video, I think, but I've been using rosehip oil in general for the past 6 months, and it has worked really well for my sunspots and my acne scarring. And I really like it. I don't use it all over my face, but I like to use it on my neck as well because I don't have a separate neck cream, and this does moisturize very, very well. Next, I use some kind of a hydrating serum because my skin is very dry, as I've said. And my favorite one is by Caudalie, and it's the Venusaur's SOS Thirst Quenching Serum. This one I've been using for about 2 years now, I guess. And it is the best. It is absolutely the best. It has the best consistency, and it is what it says, very thirst quenching. If you have dry skin or dehydrated skin, your skin is gonna drink up the serum when you apply it. It smells really great. I really, really like the packaging as well. I think that this kind of packaging is the best for a face serum. As for an eye cream, I haven't found anything that would make me go crazy about, but I really like the moisturizing eye cream by the Emu Oil Company, I think it's called. I don't know. This one is very moisturizing and it brightens up my under eye area, but again, I don't think that any eye cream would do so much for my under eye circles. And it's not that I haven't tried many brands. I've tried most of the higher end brands and most of the brands that you can find in Greek pharmacies. But again, I'm not really happy with the results I have got. The next step is moisturizer, and I like to use two different moisturizers because, as I've said, I have dry and sensitive skin, except for my nose, which is kind of a combination. So it gets oilier sometimes. And I use the moisturizing sorbet by Caudalie and the moisturizing mattifying fluid. This one I use on my nose on certain days. As I said, if you have different skin conditions on your face, you should use a different moisturizer for the different parts. So for example, if you have an oily T-zone, you should use a moisturizer for oily skin on your T-zone and another one for the rest of your face. Another moisturizer I've been liking is Claria by the Greek brand Pharmacept. This one has a lot of antioxidants and hyaluronic acid, as well as urea, omega-3 and omega-6 that are very, very important for your skin. I really like this moisturizer. I use it all over my face and it gives me radiance, and it also does a little bit of exfoliation as well because of the urea. It also says that it has vitamin C and aloe vera is really good for sensitive skin types as mine, and vitamin C has a lot of anti-aging properties. And another cream that I've been really liking is by La Roche-Posay, and the Tolerian Ultra. I talked about this in my last video and I like it a lot. This is a total life savior. It is a very intensive calming treatment, so if you have sensitive skin like me, this is a great, great moisturizer. Also, I'm gonna mention some products that I use for my lips, and I like to use these lip scrubs by Lush. I have the popcorn one and I also have the bubblegum one. I use them 2 to 3 nights a week. I find that this is the best for me. And I also use, as a night treatment for my lips, this Nuxe Rêve de Miel lip balm. This is a very popular one, but I find that this is very great for my very chapped and dry lips. I feel that this goes deep into the skin and moisturizes very well. I also feel it the next morning on my lips as well. So this was all for today. Please, if you have any product recommendations, leave them below. See you in my next video. Bye!